Okay, so I'm not completely defeated, but I've reached the end of, and clearly there's not supposed to be water there by design. And I have a feeling you're supposed to keep walking to get to it. So I'm unclear. Maybe if I could have gotten through there, I could get to that. But maybe that's also why those people back there went out to the road, maybe? I don't know. But it's all part of the adventure. So, and obviously, I mean, they put this stuff here so you can walk. And I got to be careful for this, because sometimes, and I'm only in flip-flops, sometimes these palm trees have, like, kind of ragged edges on them. So, I'd prefer to not injure myself while I'm out here by myself. So, let me get over here, find out. All right, I'm back on dry land. it's meant to be explored. I just don't know how far. I was kind of hoping. I mean, I gotta find that beach now. My God, did you see the color of that sand? Maybe you couldn't from my video or from the pictures, but that is white sand, man. I'm a fan of white sand. So, all right. Back I go. Maybe time for Google Maps. I did mention that before, but I didn't follow through on it. All right, that's what we're doing next. It's time to Google Maps. I think this is what happens when someone gets frustrated with the souvenirs from Los Cabos. So I'm back down that road where I saw those people walking back to the main road, and I'm doing that. And then I can see where people like come in. I think this is basically just, well, I mean, you saw from the screenshot, right? It's like a state park or something like that. So I'm gonna go out here. I'm gonna go out here and find out what's going on. And if I can walk to that beach, also from the screenshot, you may have seen there in the lower part, in the lower part of the picture, how there were resorts. And I think that basically may keep me between the end of this road here, if I head down this way, and going directly to the beach. But I have no doubt, for a certain amount of money, I can probably enter a resort and use their beach. Which, you know, I get it. They've paid for the real estate. Whatever. So, all right, we'll find out what's going on up here. All right, so this is the entrance to that street, and it comes off of this street here that they're not using because of the slurry they've put down. So they're actually paving the street. And again, this Fonatur thing, this Fonatur sign right there, and then it looks like Cacti Mundo. So I'm going to assume this is basically one of these resort living deals. And that sign says Los Cabos open surf June 6/11. So that either means that between June 6th and June 11th, there's a surf thing, or that sign has been up there since 2011. The latter would not surprise me. So, but these guys are putting down slurry. So, hola. See, look, it's so awesome. Like every single person I go into is like smiling and saying hello. I love it. Totally awesome. Now, there's a part of me that just before I got to the street, I saw this down there, and I was thinking, okay, well, maybe I should go down this path. And that will allow me to walk basically through the woods all the way up here. But then, obviously, this is not difficult here. So I'll do this for a little bit. I'm going to have to ask my dad, because I know my dad was a foreman years ago on projects that involved doing street work. Now, I don't know if that involves slurry like this is, where you then put sand on top, basically, or where there was an asphalt type project. I vaguely recall him telling me some stories of that, but I seem to forget them now. Now, the other good news is what I see coming there right now is a bus, which means, because I love exploring, I don't necessarily like returning. So that bus, okay, cool. It looks like that's a, you know, urban suburban bus, and it looks like it had the same writing on the side of it that the other ones did that I saw in town. And I believe Torre told me that the price of one of those buses, and again, it's not air conditioned, it's basically like an old school bus, but the cost of one of those between here, San Jose del Cabo, and Cabo San Lucas, I think he said it was like 20 pesos. So at the current exchange rate, that's about $1.25. Yeah, so the exchange place that's right down the street from my apartment, here's a picture of that. And so almost 18, 17.9, and I got 14 something at the airport. And, you know, I mean, yes, I know better in the sense that I could have gotten a better deal. But I also am fully in acceptance of the fact, and I've done this enough times, where the first time I go anywhere, it's more expensive. and then I discover all of those things. And I suppose the only real selfish thing is the fact that I don't, you know, blog extensively about that, such that the next guy who types in, where do I go in San Jose del Cabo to exchange money, gets to read an article that I put up there for free. But I don't know, maybe these videos will help somebody if they come down here. So that sign says Estero, and I don't know what that means. This is private property over here. Yes, I know, property privada. You know what's funny, as much as this place is like totally built up, it still has tons of room to grow. I don't know if you can see that in the far thing, but they're totally doing work on the, in fact, that building, that facility may not even be open yet, who knows. But, you know, here it is 2017, and I bet you in like 2010, they were like, oh yeah, we're gonna have this thing built by, just give us your down payment, right? And, but I don't know. I mean, I guess I can understand why there's not that many people here. When I used to get down to San Felipe at this time of year, it was the same deal, and it was the same temperature. It was like in the 90s, and I loved it. But all the snowbirds, as we refer to them, basically left. So, all right, I'm almost to the end here. I'm going to look around once I get here and see what it's all about. I see beach. I do see beach, and we are going to figure out how to get there. Okay, so as I walked down here, and then I saw this, I'm like, it was one of those, oh, I know where we are moments. So let me just look here and make sure I don't get hit. But the reason I know where we are is because we came from that direction. The super shuttle, who I cannot speak highly, oh, you can't see it in the distance, but there are horses down there. So that might be, so they probably take you back there when you go for your ride. But in any case, I can't speak highly enough about Super Shuttle. The customer service was outstanding. The van was absolutely clean and air conditioning worked perfectly. It was stellar. Oh, there are the horses. Okay, cool. Anyway, so what we did is we came from that road there and then made the U-turn here and then went down that street. And for whatever reason, walking down it, it didn't register that, oh yeah, I've already been down that street. So that is a Holiday Inn, and if I haven't said this before, if you're unfamiliar with Holiday Inns outside of the United States, they are stellar resorts. The Holiday Inn in Phuket is gotta be 4-star, if not 5. It is an exceptional place. The one in Pattaya, like right on the beach, it's always really great. So I think I may go in there and see what's going on, probably end up buying a water for 100 pesos or something. But in any case, yeah, so we came through there, which is super new. I mean, literally, there's shops on the left, shops on the right, and they're all, first of all, they're all brand new. Secondly, all of the signs are in English. And I was like, dude, I feel like, I mean, honestly, I feel if you were to drop me there and not tell me where I was, I would either be here in San Jose del Cabo or I would be in Phoenix. it literally looked no different. Everything is brand new, all these shops, and it's a mall and everything, and I'm just like, okay, if I wanted to do that, I would have taken a Southwest flight to Phoenix. But anyway, where I'm walking now is into the Holiday Inn. And I'm going to do that because I believe that basically way over there on the other side of all of those palm trees was where I was trying to walk to that super white strand of sand. And I believe this is down here. So I am going to go there. Because I can.